All right, y'all. So here we are, last lesson of transformations. So this is compositions of transformations. All right, and what we'll see here is we're going to see that we have a lot of, this isn't a particularly difficult one because you're just putting two different transformations together. So if you think about it, the word compose, right, to compose is to put things together, right? When you compose a piece of music, you're putting notes and music together, right? So that's all this is here, compositions of transformations. We're just putting two different transformations together and kind of making it into one action, okay? And that's it. We'll just do three examples and we will move on, all right? So we've got coordinates of the vertices below of the original triangle, SPY, right? SPY in the table below, okay? So we've got S, and I know it's probably a little bit difficult to see here. Let's zoom in so we can get, yeah, there we go. Now we're rocking. All right, so we've got, negative 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so S is at negative 6, 3. Okay, we've got P at 4, 4. We've got Y at 4, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Sometimes it's a little bit hard to see those numbers, but there it is. We've got negative 8 for that one, okay? So we're asked to do two things, right? We're going to translate the triangle 4 units up and then 6 units to the right, okay? And then using this vector, and then we're going to rotate the triangle 90 degrees. So I'm doing a few things on this one, okay? It's a lot at once, but what I recommend is actually, putting these coordinates, okay, S, P, and then Y. Okay, and let's go ahead and take care of the vector part first. So let's go ahead and do the 4 units up, 6 units to the right. So let's just understand, right, this is going to be to my Y, and this is going to be to my X. Okay, these are both positive, right? We're going to the right, that's positive. Going up, that's positive. So we're going to be doing, plus 6 here, plus 6 to my X, and then 4 units to my Y. So let's just take care of the X is first. Okay, so let's go ahead and do 6 units to the right. So that's going to be negative 6. Well, now we're at 0. Okay, 4. Now we're at 10. Right, the operation is adding. Right, we are adding 6 here. 4, still at 10. All right, and then we can do the second ones where, the 4 units up. That's going to be 3 to 7. All right, that's going to be 4 to 8. And that's going to be negative 8 to negative 4. Okay, so that's the first part, and then the second part would be just to rotate the triangle 90 degrees about the origin. So let's do that, and let's review our rule. All right, the rule for 90 degrees. Remember, these are counterclockwise. You are going to be changing, if it was X, Y, you're now going to be changing it to negative Y, X. Okay, so that's what we're going to be doing here, and then that'll be that. Okay, so let's go ahead and switch it. This is going to be my S prime. This is like my fully finished transformation. Okay, so we've got 7, 0, and then we're going to negate the left. All right, and that's going to be this one right here. So if you remember the words, right, if you're going back to the 90 degree rotation, it's two different steps, right? We got switch and then negate the one on the left. So that's what we're doing here. Got that taken care of. With P prime, all right, we're doing 8, 10. And then we will negate the left, all right? And then we've got Y prime, all right? We've got negative 4, 10, where we're switching it. But then we'll negate the left. So the left was negative, so now it's positive. Okay, so this is my completed version here. We've got negative 7, 0. We've got negative 8, 10. And then we've got 4, 10, all right? So let's go ahead and graph the new one. Why is it doing that? Making that weird flashing thing. Oh well, we'll just continue. All right, anyways, we got S prime, negative 7, 0. So that's what we're gonna put here, negative 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 0. So that's where my new one is going to be. All right, that's where my S prime is going to be. And then we've got negative 8, 10, okay, negative 8. 10, that's way up here, 3, 6, 10, there it is. That would be P prime. It's hard to see in there. And then we've got Y, and that's going to be at 4 comma 10. So 4 comma 10 up here. Okay. That is our composition transformation there. Okay, we did two different things, right? If you really wanted, you could see the intermediate steps just to see the actual translation, right? You're going to be moving up, you know, this would be somewhere in here, and then we'll do that rotation to get to that right there, all right? And that's the 90 degrees, again, counterclockwise rotation about the origin, okay? Now let's write the rule, okay? The rule here, all right? The first thing we did is we added 6, right? We added 6. And let's do an intermediate step here just to check, just like we did here, right? Intermediate step was we went from x comma y, okay, and then we added 6 to my x coordinate, and then we added 4 to my y coordinate. But then the second step, right? The second step here was when we switched these two, okay? So I'm going to take this entire thing and switch it. Okay, I'm going to take that whole thing and switch it. But then I need to make this entire thing negative, right? Because that's the two steps. We switched it, but then we make this one negative. Now, some people will just accidentally just do negative to the y. But remember, this is one coordinate, right? That represents a number. So you got to make the whole number negative. So be careful there, okay? That is negative y plus 4, and then this is x plus 6. All right, that's our first composition of transformations. You are putting two different transformations together. Let's do another example. All right, activity B. All right, we've got K, K-I-D-S, kids. Okay, so we've got negative 6 here, negative 6, comma, negative 3. And then for I, we've got negative 2, negative 2. For D, we've got negative 3, negative 6. For S, we have negative, these numbers are not fun to see, negative 7, and then 1 down, so from D, so negative 7, negative 7. Okay, so same thing here, right? We're just going to follow each of these steps, okay? So we've got K, I'm going to rewrite it so we have some space to work with. I, we've got negative 2, negative 2, D, we've got negative 3, negative 6, and then S, we've got negative 7, comma, negative 7. So let's do the intermediate step first. Okay, we're going to reflect the quadrilateral across the line y equals x. So my rule here, if you remember, is just to switch the coordinates. That's it, okay? Okay, so let's do it. Intermediate step, it was negative 3, negative 6, comma, negative 3. It's now this. Okay, then we've got negative 2, negative 2, but that remains the same. Here we've got negative 6, negative 3, and then we've got negative 7, negative 7. So we've taken care of that first part. Now we're just going to do the second part, which says to translate it 4 units down to become the quadrilateral K prime, I prime, D prime, S prime. Okay, so on this last part, 4 units down, that's going to be subtracting from my Y. So my Y is now this over here. So I'm just going to be subtracting 4 to each. So I'm going to have negative 3, negative 6 minus 4. That's going to give us negative 10. Okay, negative 2. We keep the x, but we change the y. So negative 2, I'm looking here. And we're going to subtract 4. So that's going to put me to negative 6. I'm here. I'm going to subtract the from the 3. That's going to put me to negative 7. And then negative 7. Minus 4, that's going to put me at negative 11. Okay, so there we go. And that's what we could fill in up here. I'm not going to waste y'all's time doing that. I'm just going to go ahead and label these as K prime, I prime, D prime, S prime. And let's go ahead and fill it in. Okay, K prime, negative 3, comma 10. 1, 2, 3, down to 10. There it is. Okay, I prime, negative 2, negative 6. So negative 2, 3, okay, we've got 6 there. And then we've got, let's label it K prime, that was I prime here. And we've got D prime, that's negative 6, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, And then down 7, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and then S prime, negative 7, negative 11. So there's my negative 7. Negative 11 is down here. Okay, so that's going to be your composition of transformation shape there. Okay, hard to see that actual change, right? Because it kind of just looks like a shift down. It certainly just looks like a shift down. But understand, you know, that it was a flip across this line right here, right? That y equals x line, which is approximately in there. And then we shifted it down, okay? And then this one is k prime, I prime. This one was your last one, so S prime, but D prime is here, in there. A little bit hectic in there, but that is the labeling. Man, that's bad today. I'm gonna pause it and see if I can fix it. Okay, hopefully it's a little bit better now. All right, so let's talk about the intermediate step, right? I started the rule, right? First, we're gonna flip it, right? So it's now y, comma x. Okay, and then we're going to be shifting down. So this is like my new y, right? So this other part, right? We were working with this section, okay? So the rule, right? I had it's now going to be x minus 4. Okay, so again, we're starting here. This is the flip. This is the reflection across the line y equals x. This is the switching coordinates part, and then we needed to subtract from my y coordinate slot, right? We don't want to subtract from the y because that y is really like is in the x coordinate spot, right? We wanted to subtract 4 from here, 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 and here, and that was this piece here. So it's now y, no parentheses needed here, y and then comma x minus 4, okay? And there's that one, all right? Last one, here it is. This one's going to be a little bit of a dilation, okay? A little bit of a smaller triangle. We've got W is at 1, 1. We've got I is at 2, 3. And then we've got N is at 3, 1. Okay? We're going to dilate the triangle using a center dilation of 0, 0. That's when we're just going to multiply by my scale factor. Okay? So just as a reminder, we just multiply all these numbers, every single one, by 3. Okay? And then we're going to translate it 7 units down after. Okay, to become the final product here. All right, so let's start. We've got W is 1, 1. We've got I is 2, 3. And we've got N is 3, 1. Intermediate step here, right? This is just checking off this first one, right? When we're done, we're literally going to multiply everything by 3. So 1 times 3, that's 3. 1 times 3, that's 3. 2 times 3, that's 6. 3 times 3, that's 9. 3 times 3, that's 9. 1 times 3, that's going to give me 3. So that's what I have so far. And then we'll do that last step. All right, we can check that off once we have it. Translate 7 units down to become the final product. So translating the 7 units down, we got to think, does that affect the x coordinate or does that affect my y coordinate? Translation down will always affect your y coordinate. Is that positive or negative when we're going down? That's going to be negative. So we're going to be subtracting 7 units to my y-coordinate. Okay, so I've got W prime, that's going to give me 3, comma, 3 minus 7. 3 minus 7, that's negative 4. Okay, I prime, keep the 6 here. And then we've got 9 minus 7, that's going to give me 2. Okay, and then the last one, got 9, keep the 9, and then just to look at this 3, so 3 minus 7, that's going to give me negative 4. All right, that's my final product. We could be putting that here. Let's go ahead and graph these. W prime, 3, okay, 3, and then negative 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. There it is. And by the way, since it's a dilation, we should expect and if this number is greater than 1, we multiplied it, so it's going to be bigger. It's going to be a bigger triangle than what we had before. All right, I prime, 6, comma 2, that's here. We can already see that that's bigger than what we had before. The 9, 3 over, and then down 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, there it is. There is my bigger triangle. W prime, that's I prime, that's N prime. okay? That's my final product with those coordinates. Let's do the rule. Okay, the rule, we were working with x, y. We did a scale factor of 3. So I multiplied, right? So I'm now going to be 3 times x and then 3 times y for my rule. And then what did we do? Well, we translated 7 units down. That did not affect this right here. It only affected this one. So final product, we had 3x. We got to keep that. And then we had 3y. But then we're subtracting 7. So then minus 7. Okay? And that's our rule that we will put here. Okay? And what you can do, just so you know, that rule, that means once we have that rule, you could theoretically jump from here to here. Okay? Let's just try it out. That'd be inputting my x coordinate, right? Here's my x. Well, 3 times x, I put it in that slot. There it is. It's 3. And then I take my y. And after multiplying by 3, right, so this is 1, 3 times 1, that's still 3. And then 3 minus 7, that's going to give me that negative 4, so that does check out. So you could theoretically, you know, once you have that rule, plug everything in directly using this and getting out this. That's what the rule is for, right? It's kind of a, you know, you can use it as an input, and then the output is going to be your final product and those final coordinates, okay? That is compositions of transformations. Again, that's putting multiple transformations together. You know, we've got those 4 options that we've been working with. You know, dilations, which is expanding. Translations, which is, you know, shifting the figure. Reflections, reflecting over an axis. And rotations, right? Rotating around a point, okay? That is what I have for today. You guys have a wonderful day. See you later.